This shows all of the components available for the N4372E Lightwave Component Analyzer. In many cases, less components are needed depending on the device being measured. We'll take a look at some configurations in the upcoming slides. The setup is controlled by a PNA or PNAX vector network analyzer with at least 26.5 GHz bandwidth. Higher bandwidth models can be used as well. The RF signal is up-converted and down-converted to 110 GHz with the frequency extender heads on the left and the right. Optical components include the calibrated optical transmitter and calibrated optical receiver. These are controlled by the LCA test set. The test set also contains 1310, 1550 or both CW lasers, which are routed to the modulator in the optical transmitter. This is the configuration for measuring an optical transmitter with a single-ended RF input. RF signal from the network analyzer is up-converted in the frequency extender to sweep up to 110 GHz, and that RF signal goes into the transmitter being tested. The modulated optical output of the transmitter goes to the calibrated optical receiver. This is calibrated flat in its frequency response at the factory, which converts it back to an electrical signal, down-converted by the frequency extender back into the network analyzer. We measure the frequency response of the transmitter under test. If the transmitter under test has differential inputs, then a second frequency extender connected to another port of the network analyzer and test set controller is used to provide differential stimulus to the device. The rest is the same. The optical output of the transmitter goes to the calibrated optical receiver, down converted and back into the other port of the network analyzer. This is the setup for measuring an optical receiver with a single-ended electrical output. In this case, the LCA's calibrated optical transmitter is used to provide the modulated signal to the receiver under test. The optical transmitter is factory calibrated in its response all the way up to 110 GHz. If the receiver being tested has differential outputs, then as before, a third frequency extender will be used and an additional port on the network analyzer to measure the differential response from the receiver under test. We'll now make an LCA measurement of an optical receiver with a single-ended electrical output with the setup shown here, which includes the LCA's calibrated transmitter module. The first step in an LCA measurement is to set the electrical parameters of the network analyzer, such as the IF bandwidth, the start and stop frequencies, and the frequency step size. The unit we're using here is an early prototype and is only calibrated to 100 GHz. However, current production units are fully functional and calibrated to 110 GHz. So we'll start at 10 MHz, stop at 100 GHz, with a step size of 10 megahertz. After the electrical parameters are set, the next step is to do the electrical calibration at the network analyzer's RF ports, as you normally would for RF measurements. That's already been done, so we'll move on to setting the optical parameters in the LCA setup screen. The tabs across the top are to choose the different measurement types, such as an E to O measurement, an O to O measurement, or in the case we have today, an O to E measurement. We can measure devices with differential outputs or single-ended. The device here is single-ended, so we'll leave that set there. We can choose the ports of the network analyzer that are used. We have our calibrated transmitter connected to PNA port 3, and our receiver device under test electrical output connected to the network analyzer's port 4. But we could connect those to other ports as well and select them there. We'll be measuring with a source wavelength of 1550 nanometers, and we'll let the use the default modulator optimization, the bias control, Leave that in an automatic and let it bias itself. There's a couple other things down the bottom we can do if we want optical path de-embedding, such as maybe if we had an attenuator in there with a certain number of dBs of attenuation, we could de-embed that from the measurement or offset that. Or we can do RF path de-embedding. A common example of this using this would be de-embedding the frequency response of probe tips when we're doing on-wafer measurements. It's ready to go, and we'll start the measurement. It's preparing the optics, and then we can run continuous measurements over and over, or we'll just run a single measurement now. And in just a minute, the measurement will start, and we'll see the trace come up. And there we have it. The blue trace is S43, which is the responsivity of the receiver out to 100 gigahertz. The yellow trace is S44. That's the output electrical return loss of the receiver. Thanks for watching this short video. You can find information on the N4372E and all of our Lightwave component analyzers at the link shown at the bottom of the screen.